Let's practice. So you be Daryl Van Horn and I'll, of course, be me.
Was that really?
Mr. Van Horn, I'm surprised to see you here.
See, already I think that that's weird because are we really surprised to see him? I mean, this is a bar and it's a party and it's a party kind of guy.
Oh, please, just let me finish. Mr. Van Horn, I'm very surprised to see you here. You must be exhausted after killing my boyfriend.
No, you can't say that.
Oh, Mr. Van Horn? Penny, wait, wait.
Ah, Penny, don't you look fetching? And Joanna, you look... erratic.
Thank you, Daryl.
Okay, enough with the banter. Tell us what you know about Jamie.
Excuse me?
Jamie Dalton. You killed his mother. Ring any bells?
See, Penny and I are trying to retrace Jamie's last few days here in Eastwick because Penny is on a mission to find out what happened to him, and I said that I would help. So we were hoping that maybe you could tell us when the last time you saw Jamie was.
Why are you talking to him like he's a deaf person?
You know, to tell you the truth, our paths rarely crossed. I don't think he liked me.
I don't think you liked him. And I think that you'd stop at nothing to get him out of Eastwick.
Stop at nothing?
I know you had something to do with his disappearance, so we can either do this the easy way, or we can do it the hard way.
I'll take it hard.
The police know that it was foul play. So, I think someone got rid of him. I think someone dumped his car in the lake to make it look like he skipped town.
You know, Penny, I'm a businessman. And if I wanted Jamie out of Eastwick, I would have simply offered him money. And he would have taken it, because no matter what people say, everyone has their price.
See, Penny and I always play that game. You know, who would you sleep with for $1 million? And you would be surprised how low Penny would...
Also, I would never have left his car in some lake waiting to be found, because that's sloppy. And I may be many things, but I am not sloppy. So I would encourage you to check your facts before you make wild accusations. But I forgive you, because I know this is just the grief talking. And if I understand anything, I understand pain. Now, if you girls will excuse me, I am dying for a mojito.
I think that went well.
Are you kidding?